Pittsburgh's trying to play fast right now. A lot of indirect passes up the boards, trying to create some speed against the Flyers defense. This injury to Nick Grossman is a pretty significant thing. Flyers got to get going here.
Danny Briere to the net. Left hand saved by Fleury. Richard Park and Joe Vitale as Crosby has turned aside. Fiverr's gone off.
See, Kenny, that's what I mean by playing fast. They're doing it all the time, Pittsburgh. Trying to make those indirect passes up the wall.
Philadelphia leading the series 3-1. Carl had his shot blocked, and then Briere with an opportunity turned aside by Fleury. Blocked by Cook. Carl pinching. Heath Jordan stall for the puck. Dogger had it knocked off his stick. Puck comes up the boards. Big hit by Stahl on Giroux. His shot gets blocked. And it's Hartnell back into the Pittsburgh zone. 3-on-2. Now a backhand shot is stopped by Fleury off the stick of Giroux.
And that's Sidney Crosby interpretation. An imitation. Come in on the backhand. Crosby's known for having the backhand, and Fleury's like, do I have it? Yeah, you do. And Hartnell's trying to play a little bit with him and his mind.
From the right circle from Voracek, sails wide. Hartnell with a chance. Blocked in front by the glove of Orpik, and then kept in the zone by Hartnell. He is lined up by Orpik. And the puck winds up in the catching glove of Marc-Andre Fleury. Up the left side for Matt Reed, led all rookies in scoring during the regular season. And the Flyers take a 1-0 lead on the wrist shot from the right circle off the stick of Matt Carl.
And Saul, he's one of the guys that's going to have to pick it up without Nick Grossman in the lineup. Watch Fleury. I think he gets off the angle, Kenny, just a little bit. See how he's overplaying? He's overplaying just a little bit because he's trying to track through the traffic. And they think there's goalie interference on Fleury. Watch him just sneak over there. He's a little off the angle because of that little movement. Dupuis in the way. But there's no way that's goalie interference. Pierre doesn't touch him until the puck goes past. But Fleury put himself in a goaltending play by Fleury.
The 10th power play goal of the series for the Philadelphia Flyers. It came with 2 seconds remaining on the Englund Minor. First of the series for Matt Carl. Reed has the puck for Couturier. A 2-on-1 for the Flyers. Now a 3-on-2. Couturier stopped, and then a big save by Fleury on the rebound. Stopping Matt Reed.
25!
Now out to tag. Far side of the shot. Score! Power play goal, Steve Sullivan.
Oh, composure by Christopher Letang at the top. For the Pittsburgh Penguins. He's handled some tough punts, knocking fans on it, but keeps it alive. Then James Neal, really good skill. That fake shot forces Breeze Gallop to stand pat. And because he does, look how slow Breeze Gallop is to react to that puck in a one-timer. Right there by Sullivan. He has to bite on what.
Tied at 1, just over 4 minutes to play, first period. Power play goals from Carl and Sullivan. This is Tiemannin setting up Giroux, who hits the post. Set off for Giroux. Down low to Briere. Cross ice pass, score! Another power play goal, and Scott Hartnell, 2-1 Philadelphia.
Hartnell's first goal in the series. He was a power play scoring machine for the Flyers this race. And you look at it, face-off win so they can get all set up. Now scramble mode. And watch the rotation. Hartnell's taking it from Orpik. And as soon as the puck comes to Briere, he knows to slide off. Nice saucer pass up and over Orpik. And then up and over Fleury. That's great 5-on-3 power play development. And a nice finish by Hartnell. Fleury got a piece, but not enough of a piece.
Hartnell 37. Now McCullough backs it around. Braden Coburn, pass to the left wing for Giroux. Rough pass and a big save by Fleury with the left pad on Jágr. Penguins moving right to left here in period two. Puck deflected in by Kennedy. Adams takes Shen to the boards. Kennedy plays the puck for Dupuis.
Look at Couturier. He wins another one. That's why Buzgalov freezes a puck a lot, or tries to.
Wellwood forced the puck in. Stick saved by Fleury on Couturier. Now it's Sullivan. Forced back by Gustafsson. Tancredi with a shot. Knocked out by the glove of Krzyzgolov. Sullivan had a chance and could not get the puck to the net. Scored in the first period. All three on the power play. Now an opportunity for Staal. He scores. Jordan Staal ties the game at two.
Another example of playing fast. Hammered up the ice. Good chip play by Kennedy. We've seen Jordan Staal do this before. He did it to Bobrovsky in game number four. Coming down. Looks the goalie off. High glove side. The score is tied. It all started in the neutral zone. And it finished with a great shot by Jordan Staal. Jordan Staal's got that spot down, and let's go to game four and watch game four, Kenny. Here he is against Bobrovsky. Same play. Boom. He's got his spot, Kenny.
And our fans to be at their best tonight. Malkin walks in. Backhand shot. He missed the net. Biskinen. Across to Dupre. Shoots wide. Hard count off the end boards. And it's kept out by Krzyzgolov, and then shot off the side of the net by Kunitz.
The series play fast. Long passes, chip, and Evgeny Malkin goes to work on a two-on-one with James Neal. It's a nice back check coming back by Couturier, but then you'll see the big carom that Kenny was just talking about, and Krzyzgolov got a whole lot of...
He tied the game moments ago. Matt Cook with the puck. Out to the right circle. Kennedy has room. He scores! Tyler Kennedy gives the Penguins their first lead of game five.
And it was a long sequence for the Flyer forwards. It's a nice job by Matt Cook, keep it alive. You see the doors open. Kennedy just came off, so he got lost in coverage. He gets the feed from Cook, blasts the puck, and then gives his best impression of a Lambeau leap into the glass.
Only two shots this period. Penguins just scored two goals in the second. Jordan Staal had the first. He has the puck. This is Kennedy. He scored the second goal of the period. Saved by Krzyzgolov. 30 seconds gone on the Malkin penalty. Voracek powering down the left wing. Simmons shoots. Left hand saved by Fleury. Fleury by McCollum. Two on two. Kunitz with Adams. Now joined by Malkin. Beautiful feed from Kunitz to Malkin. He goes barreling into Krzyzgolov, and the puck stayed out of the net. By Brian Strait, one of seven defensemen of the Pittsburgh lineup tonight. Cook tries to center. It's blocked off. Niskanen with a drive. Stick save Krzyzgolov. Worked out to the point by Kennedy. Good shift for the Penguins. Straight hard period. We've played 4 minutes. Penguins lead by a goal. Neal down the left wing. Wrist shot. Oh, glove save. Big stop by Krzyzgolov.
Neal coming with a head of speed. Niskanen finds him. He blows hard on Braden Coburn. And then Krzyzgolov snags it out of the air. Now you know why James Neal had 40 goals during the regular season. That's some kind of release.
He was fourth in the lead, and he came over from Dallas in that trade last season along with James Neal.
For Alex Goligoski, who's fit in very well down in Dallas. I know that in the playoffs, but Goligoski's fit in very well there. Trade to help both teams.
Penguins clear. We'll play the points. Hartnell, Giroux, and Simmons up front. Timonen for Giroux. Timonen fires. Saved through a screen by Fleury with Simmons setting up in front. Shen and Jager. A minute to go on his Flyer power play. Giroux, left circle, wrist shot, saved by Fleury. And then Shen gets knocked down by Staal. Pierre and Staal on the draw. Giroux, left wing circle, backs it up, then throws in front. Puck is loose, and another big stop by Fleury. What a save on Danny Briere. Here's Coburn, long shot, saved by Fleury. Then a centering pass and another save. Hartnell with the opportunity. Fleury made the stop. Here's Gustafsson cutting wide. And he throws it across for Voracek. Voracek with a backhand shot. Another big save by Fleury with all kinds of traffic going on in front.
Well, Orpik's just marked.
So does this mean they're not going to call any penalties now, Kenny?
Well, if they didn't call Orpik on Van Riemsdyk, I guess not. Here's Kennedy down the left wing. Kennedy shoots. Safety's gone. Loose in front of the backhand. Just wide by Stahl.